What's up, gang? Then let me start this over. Everybody's gonna make fun of me for saying gang again. Welcome to the ForeignGotEm Deconstructed. Because Genius is not inviting me to do any of the songs that I did, I gotta do my own. I'll tell Genius to invite me, bro. ForeignGotEm Deconstructed. So first of all, we got our water. And second of all, because we know we're not trying to catch no coronavirus, we got a hand sanitizer. This is my favorite one, it smells super nice. Smells super nice. I haven't made a beat without using hand sanitizer in weeks, bro. Yep. You guys ready? You guys ready for the deconstructed? What's that loop? That's the hand sanitizer, bro. Come on. Come on, bro. You gotta stay safe in this really, really bad times. Welcome to the foreign show. Yeah. Okay, so let's start with Boom Boom Room. Okay? Genius Deconstructed, Roddy Ricch, Boom Boom Room, produced by ForeignGotEm, Young Glenn, and Kilo Keys. I'm gonna show the screen and everything, of course. So you can slide across the keys. Yeah. Bro, even if you catch the shit, you'll still be good. I'm not trying to catch no shit, bro. Okay, my Apple Studio is just loading up. Give me a second. So, how Boom Boom Room happens, I met Roddy when I was in Paris with Tyler and Post Malone, and they just introduced me. I talked to him, I talked to his managers. We just started working. We made a song like the day later. This wasn't that song though. We got like six more songs. So, yeah. I made it like me, Kilo, and Young Glenn. I made the loop. I sent it to Kilo and Young Glenn, and they made the whole beat, and then we sent the beat to Roddy's manager, and he made a song in like August, I think. So here it is. This is the loop. This is how everything started. This is the melody from Boom Boom Room. Deconstructed. The first thing I did is I used ample sound guitar. I don't know, M? I don't know which one that is. It's an acoustic guitar though. So this is what it sounds like. Then I added another layer because I don't know why I couldn't do it in the same layer, but it's the same guitar, same effects, everything. At the end, I added this little thing which made it so much harder. I forgot I made it. I don't make anything as fire as this right now. Kind of be having beat block. Next thing I did is I added this pad thing, string thing, whatever it is, from this VST called Solina, I think. It's a cool VST. Yay, sample guitar, bro. Sample guitar. Next thing. The next thing is the flute. And that's Redtron SE. That's a free flute plugin, which I got from one of Bass Gutta's videos, man. Shout out to Bass Gutta. I also used this same flute VST for the shut up beat for the baby. I'm gonna talk about it later. Call up. Okay, so this is the flute. Like, it's really fire. I use it a lot. I still use it, actually. And the last thing, the thing everybody wanted to know about, is the vocals. The vocals are from Output Arcade. Of course it's from Output Arcade. What else would ForeignGotEm use? But yo, listen, I made this loop in March 2019. So that was way before and everybody else was on Output Arcade. I was one of the, bro, I swear I was one of the first people to use Output Arcade heavy. So yeah, this is the vocals. I think I did something to them. With the effects, yeah, with the effects, I added autotune, reverb, low filter, and parametric EQ. This is what it sounded without the effects. Yeah. Okay, so. That's boom boom boom. I didn't do the drums on this song, so I'm only showing the loops, the melodies. I mean, I'm just showing what I did. Okay, what do you want to hear next? What's the next one you wanna see, hear, learn about, talk about? Freak better be here. That man is about to record me and put me on YouTube, and everybody's gonna hate me. Like, oh, you should have just waited for Genius to hit you up. They would never hit me up. You won't live this wild. Let's do Shut Up first, and then I'm gonna do Live This Wild. I'm gonna do Shut Up first, and then I'm gonna do Live This Wild. But the worst thing happened to me while I was making Shut Up. Actually, not while I was making Shut Up, later on. I actually just realized this today. While I was making Shut Up, I used this. It was a really, I don't know, heavy VST or whatever. Like, it was really heavy on my computer. So when I was making chords, I had to bounce it to wave so my CPU wouldn't be going crazy. And when I bounced it to wave, I deleted the MIDI file and the channel and everything. So for the chords, I only have the wave file, bro, and I'm super mad about it. I still get the flute though. Let me show you. Oh no, I'm definitely gonna go to Genius for something else, but like for these songs, nah. How did I get in touch? Okay, so yeah, I didn't speak about that. I never got in touch with the baby. I never talked to the baby. I mean, he tagged me, and now I have open DMs with him and all that, but we never actually met. I randomly, like not randomly, I hit up DJ Kid, his producer, DJ, a couple of months ago, I think it was like October, September, October. And I was like, yo, let's work, I got loops for you. And he was like, bet, send them over. And I sent him a pack. I literally sent him one pack with, this was the first loop that I ever sent him. I had no idea he used any of the loops. I had no idea. I had no idea. Like, first of all, I had no idea he was using my loops. Second of all, even like, I had no idea that baby made a song. I was having dinner. I was in a restaurant. I was having dinner with my family. And out of nowhere, I just like see hella DMs from people like, yo, check out the baby's new song, check out the baby's new song. And I go to YouTube and I hear, and I'm like, bro. I'm like, bro, this is my loop. And DJ Kid hit me up too, and he was like, bro, we got a hit. Yeah, I'm credited now. I'm tagged, credited, paperwork is done, all of that. So yeah, everything is cool now, but I've never talked to the baby. DJ Kid did the drums. Okay, so this is how Shut Up was made. It's literally just the chords and the flute. So yeah, I mean, it's kind of lame that I don't have the chords. I don't even remember which VST I used for the chords, bro. It's crazy. But yeah, this is what the chords sound like. But I remember I used Camel Crusher. I used Camel Space. No, what is it called? Camel Space. Yeah, I used Camel Space to get this effect on it. It has kind of like a spacey effect. Doesn't matter. So yeah, that's it. And the fluid is Retron SE. VST is Redtron SE, same as Boom Boom Room. I swear, bro, this VST changed my life, and it's a free VST. And it's also not just the flute VST. You got a flute in there. You also got like a violin, I think. Shout out to DJ Kid for making that happen. Okay, what's next? Next is Live This Wild. Okay, so for Live This Wild, I didn't do the melodies. The melodies were done by Rio Leiva. Y'all know Rio, of course y'all know Rio. So this is This is what Live This Wild looks like.
this one was so easy to make because Rio really, really killed the loop. So all I did is added a cymbal, a kick, an 808, clap, snare, hi-hat, and another 808 pattern. I swear, bro, that's really all there is to it. And of course, Mosey. But I guess like the only fun thing about this, the only fun thing that I did for on this beat was I made different 808s for the hook and the verse. So here it starts with a high note. In the hook it starts with a high note and goes down. And in the verse it starts with a low note, like the same note that's here, but just like an octave lower, and then goes up. So this is the difference. And this is. Yeah. That's Lil as well. Didn't make this in front of Mosey. No, I made this here in this room. It was August, I remember, yeah, it was August, and I made his beat after Rio sent me the loop. I immediately sent it to Mosey, and the next day he just sent me a video of himself. He just texted me a video of himself, just like singing the hook to the song. And like, bro, immediately I was like, this one is going to be a single for sure. Is that a whole different 808? In the final version, it's a whole different 808. In this one, it's the same 808. But in the final version, the Royce did that. Royce changed the 808 during the verse in the final version. What's the next one you want to hear? I feel like I showed enough of this one, because I can't really show you how the melody was made, because Rio did that. It's difficult to link with artists. Not really. I mean, it is if you, I don't know, just be patient and it will become easy. Where you live, bro? I live in Belgrade, Serbia. Okay, let me show you this one. I'm not gonna say which one this is. I mean, y'all are gonna recognize, of course, but I'm not gonna. You're gonna hear it first. I wanna see the master channel trick, bro. I don't have a master channel trick. I just put isotopes on it and put the gain all the way, I think it's called gain, all the way down, or all the way, I don't know. I just put an isotopes on and it makes it sound louder, and that's it. Yeah, I produced Boom Boom Room by Roddy. I literally just showed how I made the beat. Okay, I'm playing. Song. It just dropped last summer. I mean, I guess it was never that big. YNWB Slime Slime Dreams. The first song YNWB Slime YNW Melis
little brother came, like, got in the game with. That's the first song he dropped. Yeah. Doesn't matter. I'm a B-Slime, YNW B-Slime. I mean, it's still his biggest song. Has like, I mean, it's not that big. It has like, what, 15 million streams views. But yeah, let me show you how I made it, because it's one of my favorite loops I made. When I made it, I actually made it with Juice WRLD. Not with Juice WRLD. I was like, with Juice WRLD in my mind, I was like thinking Juice WRLD will kill it. So what I used is SRX keyboards and Omnisphere and Solina. I don't know how you pronounce this, bro. Doesn't matter. This is SRX keyboards. The other layer is Omnisphere. If I remember right, it's from a Nick Mira Omnisphere bank. Yep, Nick Mira Luna Omnisphere bank. Same melody, just a different layer. Appreciate you guys, for real. And just this layer of strings, pads, whatever. What kind of percentages does a loop maker get? So it can be whatever, but my thing is that I never really got to loop maker treatment, because I was like, at the same time I make loops, but I also make beats and I have big songs of my own, like big songs that I produced and placed. So like, for me, it's not that, like, I don't feel like the producers I work with, or like the labels, I don't feel like they think of me as a loop maker, even though I make loops a lot and I get a lot of placements with my loops, but I always get 50%, and they never even try to give me nothing else, because they know that I get songs on my own too, and that I can get them songs with their loops. But like, for smaller producers who don't get placements on their own, I feel like it can be a little bit more rough, because they're gonna be like, okay, so this is your first placement, I can just give you whatever. But I don't do that at all. Like, when I get a placement to a producer, like when I help a producer get a placement, like when I get a placement with using one of you guys' loops, I always do 50% for sure. You make a play, how do you get money, how much do you ever, the labels wire you the money to your bank. You really are the most underrated, bro. You're right, you stupid. Appreciate you, bro. Did you see Mosey trying to make a better version of Fluid Spot? What do you mean better version of Fluid Spot? I didn't see that. What do you mean? I'm not gonna show chopsticks, because I don't remember where the FOP for chopsticks is. That shit is like how old? It was like two years ago. Okay, so I'm not gonna show any more. I'm not gonna deconstruct any bro, what am I talking about? But I'm gonna show you this beat I just made. I'm gonna show you this beat I just made, and it's like, it's an 80s beat. Sounds like Blinding Lights, kinda, but also not really. Did you see Mosey previewing Big Body on Live? Yeah, we made a beat together. Me and Mosey made a beat together. He did all the drums on there. Roddy Ricch, he was in Airbnb and said he was trying to make a better version of Lil Mosey with another producer. I don't think so, because he was in Puerto Rico after his album dropped, I think. Yeah. Anyways, here's the beat that I made. I literally made this like an hour ago or even less. Save this live, so if you guys want to see something again, just you can just comment, like you can just get on my profile and open up the live, because it's gonna be there for like what, 24 hours I think. He was probably with Royce or Kid Culture in the log. He's probably what he's thinking. I don't know, I'm gonna check out the log and let me see. Appreciate y'all for watching. Peace, ForeignGotEm.